camera on that box there. And then disappeared, and then came out again and took off. And I got all in one.
Yeah.
One amazing sequence.
Oh, what?
Yes, it stopped many a club meeting now.
Good.
Or there's one club I go to, and they had the speaker, and at half time I showed them a film, and it even stopped them drinking their tea and having a chat. It takes a lot.
Yeah.
Isn't that like most clubs?
I was surprised it didn't stop them speaking to you.
The Irish Osprey's gone to the other net side.
Well, yeah, it hasn't attracted a mate up there.
I might include that in the Christmas quiz.
You have an evil turn about you.
Well, I did suggest they keep. You know, you get landed. If you do something well, you get landed on.
Yeah.
Well, I did suggest, you know, 20 goals, name, sort of thing. But it doesn't seem to stop them. So what's that for? Is that Rutland House or something like that?
I think it is. Yeah.
It's a bit grand, pretentious.
Well, they owned all of this, whoever it was.
So. Yeah. I think that's a ha-ha up there.
I don't see anything to laugh about.
Yeah. Only if you fall into them. Yeah. See someone else fall out of.
That, if it is, it's a particularly high one.
Yeah. You know the factory down the road from me in Tiverton? There's a
not that intimately. I haven't been to Tiverton once in my life.
There's a ship materials factory down there.
Yeah.
And there's 1700. The first one was built there in 1700s. And the guy that owned it built all the houses around there for his workers.
Uh-huh.
And he walked his workers from here, from Rutland.
Yeah.
Down to Tiverton in 11 days. Fed and watered them all the way down.
Really?
And then put them into the new houses. Took his label with him.
Egyptian goose flying.
Is that what I'm watching? I wonder what it was.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, you can see a big amount of white on the wings.
Yeah.
I have seen him in Africa in the right place, really. That's the same, really.
Oh, I see what you mean. I can actually see the white now. Well, you were trying to get me to see that kind of silhouetted sky last night, weren't you?
Well, it was dark.
I mean, quite, yeah.
Oh, that old excuse.
Yeah.
I was up in Scotland, and the excuse for our missed sighting was that the bird was wet.
Oh, yeah.
That was a new one. I have to go put that down.
It was under 3 foot of water at the time as well.
We're
different leaders' excuses. The bird was wet, it was dark, it had its back to us.
Going the other way, though, we were very lucky last night. We'd left some kit behind, so I had to go back to pick it up. And driving along the road, we had a brilliant view of a female sparrowhawk.
It's not your water bottle,
is it? No. That's a trailer behind it.
As long as you're not getting towed away.
I wonder if my car's still down.
Well,
I was up on Staines last weekend. Blackneck Greaves.
I've been out for them once this year and couldn't get them yet.
We had blackneck greaves on a thunderstorm.
Not make a picture that, would you?
Could do the black. Usually blackneck greaves tend to be about a mile and a half away from the water, don't they?
Right.
Actually, I got some good views last year.
Threshing and parched.
No, it's just somebody in Birdwatch magazine is reviewing the latest net on digital SNR, which has got insanely fast sensor speed.
Right.
But you lose it, most of the quality when you do that. And he said he'd never ever want to. He said he'd never ever want to do that. He said, but then maybe one day, you know, it's a foggy night off on North Northumberland coast and the hawk owl flies past.
The bird was wet, but it was dark.
His workers from here, from Rutland.
Yeah.
Down for 11 days.
I was surprised it didn't stop him speaking to you.